The Marine Corps Warfighting Lab panel looked at a lot of science technology that the Corps is going to need for future warfare and future fighting.
We have a very good understanding of the threat that's out there. Everything we do is threat-based. We know the threat, we understand the threat, we get briefed on the threat almost daily. And all our work is focused on countering the threat that's out there.
One such technology is now available on two different drones the Marines are currently using or will soon use, and that is terrain avoidance technology. Essentially, a drone can fly at low altitude around terrain features without a pilot. A Marine could set that route in a tablet, set it off to fly, and it could deliver cargo, run a scouting mission, look for targets, or relay communications. Those different drones, the TRV-150 and the Cayman Cargo, do different mission sets. The cargo, of course, carries heavier loads, and one day something like this could carry even a Marine off the battlefield for medical care. The smaller drones could do site reconnaissance, look out for route planning, and help Marines on mission see what's over that next hill. The autonomous feature can take the load off the Marine and the squad by removing the need for a drone pilot. Essentially, by setting that route and putting that drone out there in the terrain, they can do other tasks while the drone takes care of the mission, and then call that back or use that drone in different ways depending on what they need for the next mission set or task assigned to them.
We're looking at everything. There's really nothing off the table, whether it's air, surface, or subsurface. There's open source efforts out there by DARPA, like such as Liberty Lifter, that's interesting. A lot of the open source stuff is we're looking at it or are involved in it one way or the other. But again, nothing is off the table.
In recent years, the Marine Corps has been conducting force design, basically redesigning the force for new features and capabilities, new technologies, and new opponents or peers, such as Chinese and Russian military. A key feature of that from the very beginning that the Marine Corps wants is autonomous systems that are cheap, affordable, and disposable. Essentially, if one of these drones goes down, it doesn't end the mission, and it doesn't take out a pilot or a major aircraft like an Osprey or an F-35. By having these autonomous systems, the Marine Corps can have more Marines in different locations, see more, sense more, and do more. That's a major feature of the science and technology research, and one feature that's already reaching the field for a lot of Marines.
So we have several programs that we're working specifically on autonomy. They originated in the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab. One you'll see right around the corner here, the TRV-150, which Near Earth Autonomy has put autonomy on that platform, is now working that. It is actually handled now as a program for PMA-263. Additionally, you'll look over at Command and you'll see cargo over there. That also is autonomy that was born out of the platform that you see behind us with Near Earth Autonomy that is in the audience, has been working on that autonomy. We're also working some other potential autonomy on some surface platforms that we're working. Right now, they're just concept designs. We're working very closely with Combatant Craft and Carter Rock Division on those platforms. So we're thinking about autonomy across the board, air, surface, and we're also working on some ground autonomy systems too, relative to vehicles that the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab has been working on for quite a few years. And we're trying to get those now into the fleet. So it's been an evolving process. As you can see, some of them are transitioning and some of them are still in a state of maturity, or mature.
That's just some of the technology here at the Modern Day Marine Expo. This is Todd South with Military Times.